Again, a little bit of a Civilization 4. This is part 2, so make sure and check out part 1 if you haven't. We are Zara Yaqob of Ethiopia. So Zara is creative and organized. And we're in a little bit of a... It's a fractal map. So we're currently here just... we've only met 3 other civs. So Egypt is our direct neighbor. And then we have Augustus Caesar down here. And Shaka, I feel like I saw him over here. I don't remember. We haven't seen his land yet. When we in the end of our last stream, we had just teched aesthetics and traded it for alphabet. And then, so we kind of put a pause there and kind of had to figure out what we were going to do next. I see 2 main options here. It stinks that neither Augustus or Hattie will trade math, because I really would like math. We would be able to get iron working from Hatshepsut. I'm a little worried if we don't do that right now that he will trade this to her. I'm trying to look and see if she got anything that she could trade him. No, not right now, I think. I'm reading this. So we could trade alphabet. We still have alphabet over her, which we probably do want to trade. I think it's saying we can't trade that right now just because we just... or maybe I don't have alphabet, actually, now that I think about it. Again, it's been a few days since I played. Okay, no, I do have alphabet. Yeah, so maybe I think I just traded it this turn. I just traded aesthetics for alphabet because I had to get enough beakers in alphabet for Augustus to trade. So my 2 paths I see one going up through priesthood to get code of laws. The religion for code of laws is not founded yet, and in fact there are no religions here on this continent, so getting a religion would be nice. The other option would be up through literature and getting the great library. I have a pretty good capital here, a pretty good bureaucracy capital here. So, actually, why don't you do that? So that would be nice. We are scheduled, we're running a couple of great scientists right now. So I could then use Code of Laws to bulb philosophy. An academy here would be not a bad thing, so that would be right now. Academy is 100%? I can't remember. It's been a while. Let's see. Buildings, academy, 50%. So yeah, that would be, right now at current sliders, 10 or so beakers a turn, which, that's 20% of my civ's total science, and probably more because that's inflated by the fact that I'm running scientists everywhere. And we want to hire some scientists here as well. Right now we're basically just working cottages everywhere. Why don't you run a scientist instead of that? And really, you're working that tile? Well, you can't run a scientist. Well, I guess, that's okay. I'm going to double whip the granary here next turn, so... Okay. So my scout can move. I think I have open borders I have open borders, so I'll go ahead and just move him in and kind of explore some of that. So I think right now I'm going to just save gold for a couple of turns. Either way, I'm gonna want mysticism next, probably. I could trade for mysticism, but that would be... I don't want to do that. Because getting these cheap techs is usually not a good idea because... that we fear you are becoming too advanced mechanism in the game. So you can see I'm putting all my points into Hattie. She's going for calendar right now. So really, in the mid game, I basically want to take over all this stuff. Maybe vassal her and leave her with this stuff. And that's probably enough to win, my guess would be. So we'll see how that ends up going. Code of Laws would be nice just for the ability to run... caste system, though, since I'm not spiritual, that's a little bit less important. currency would be big to be able to build wealth. I mean, I don't really want to build this city here just because it's really a junk city. I have one guy here fogbusting, who is fogbusting. I think I have every tile fogbusted between him and my borders, so I'm pretty free from barbarians. Excuse me right now, which is nice. Alright, I think let's go ahead and we'll see if she gets aesthetics in the inner turn. And nope, she did not. So I have aesthetics and alphabet over her. You can see that Augustus already has polytheism and can read and can already research literature. He is also industrious. So I'm a little nervous that he would be going for the Great Library. I don't really have a lot of forests to be able to even chop it out. And not a ton of production at Axum. I mean, I can take these hills, and I got three hills basically. So that would be, basically 10 a turn. The Great Library is like a couple hundred. Yeah, 350. So, yeah. This guy is unhappy, so, alright, well, let's hire two scientists here. We don't want to do that. Yeah, so that's probably good, and then we can maybe grab this. See, so he's got Mediolanum here. That is city number 7 for him. So yeah, he's pretty far away here. I mean, there is. I'd be interested. Yeah, here we go. This is Shaka's territory right here. Yeah, so he probably is bordering Augustus on the north. I don't have a ton of good resources here. To get to Coat of Laws at max science, I would need 591 beakers and 800, and the rest of this, I call it 900 beakers, so maybe 9 turns of gold, so maybe up to about 150, 180 gold. Well, less than that, because as I'm running max gold, I am still getting 15 beakers a turn. So yeah, maybe 2 or 3 more turns of saving gold, and then make a run to Coat of Laws. And the Oracle's probably gone by now, right? I would imagine so. Nope. This guy here. Okay, yeah, Oracle. Yeah, not having the pyramids or the Great Lighthouse here is not great. Put one turn into a road there. And I'm really going cottage heavy here. I'd like to have some wonders to build also, just for some wonder fail gold. But again, that's not super effective. I mean, it's not that much better than wealth. I mean, not that I can build wealth, but it's better than building units, but I'm not industrious, nor do I have stone or marble. Tech-wise, okay, so we're still up aesthetics and alphabet. He still hasn't researched literature, and neither of them will trade me math. I mean, I really just don't want to... I really want to be able to get math. I have a strong preference for math over ironworking, just because math is going to lead me to currency and lots of other good things. Alright. Oops, I forgot to double whip that. I should have done that last turn. That was dumb. house because I don't have sailing. But I can build research, which really I probably should be doing. Build a library. Alright, I forgot about that. So, let's... I don't really need these barracks right now, so let's build research. We can keep doing that. I don't know. So then... Monarchy would be nice. I do have wines. And hereditary rule would be good and to grow a little bit better. Move up here and make a cottage here. Mapping out Augustus's land, see what he's got. Okay, no changes here on the screen. Nothing going on exciting there. Yeah. We know, why don't you finish the Hanging Gardens or whatever so that we can trade that. So that's what we want. We want math. Alright, so there's Rome. No, there's nothing really to build here, so we'll... research after that. And let's turn this on so we still have no code of laws. Going there and cottaging that. Gondar will grow to size 6. We really don't want him to grow to size 6 because he's just... Yeah, so really, let's do that. And we don't want to stop working these cottages just because they're, like, very good. I think we probably do want to work some of these cottages after we get a scientist out of here. And just to kind of grow those. Yeah, we really do need hereditary rule, really. Alright, still nothing. Come on, Hanging Gardens.
Nature herself has imprinted on the minds
now
of
we're
all
go meditation.
The idea of God.
We must have already put some beakers into that. Maybe that's overflow of beakers. The reason that I talk about the Hanging Gardens is just because most... I don't know why they're not trading this. I think that we don't want to start trading the way this is because they're building a wonder, and so mathematics would be the Hanging Gardens. Though, yeah, they haven't built that yet, obviously. We just got Praetorians, so you can work this now. So looking okay here. Let me check tech-wise. So he still hasn't researched literature, which is good. Picking up meditation would give me... No, she will trade meditation. Sorry. He won't trade meditation. Yeah, so I guess here I could put gold into... or hammers into Schwigampaya. Temple of Arthur. I think the Parthenon. No, I don't think the Parthenon's gone. But meditation I want just because that will let me bulb philosophy. Yeah, so I'll have a great scientist here. Which will give me 10 extra beakers a turn. Let's see. We'll look once next turn once he's founded. To see.
Meditation brings wisdom. Lack of meditation leaves ignorance.
So
no wealth
this guy,
would lead
so
you forward.
An academy would give me 11 beakers, return settling. No, not that. No, not that either. Okay. Yeah, so that would give me 7 gold right now a turn. So I'm going to go ahead and put an academy there. Do I have open borders? I don't think I have open borders with him. Maybe I do. I'm going to go ahead and gift him that. Just for, since everybody has that. Start putting this thing because then this chop's going to go in for that, which would be useful. Okay, still no changes here. They don't want to trade. The Oracle's gone. I don't know why. I mean, it'd be nice if these guys got currency too. That way I could trade some of these techs for gold too. Really? Nope. Not happening. I would love to give you aesthetics. Why are you doing this to me?
The Lord would bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.
It would be nothing. I would like nothing more than to give you aesthetics for mathematics. So it's only your own fault here. Okay, so okay, so he's got 9 cities here. So yeah, they're all. Shaka is winning actually, score wise. Oh, I have gold. Oh, I must be trading for that with Hattie. I must have forgotten about that. Oh, I'm trading it for Shaka. Okay, so yeah, then I definitely want to be. In fact, I probably want to work these mines. So after this chop comes in, I'll swap over here. If you haven't done the wonder of building economy is basically you build a bunch of wonders, and then when it when the wonder you get a hammer of 1 gold per 1 coin. Basically, for every hammer you have invested in a wonder, you get fail gold. And so normally, that you know, that's no real different than researching wealth, except number one, I can't research wealth because I don't have currency, and number two, when you have multipliers, so in this case, if you're industrious or if you have the doubling resource, so now here, I'm getting 20 hammers, but it's getting doubled because I have access to gold, so that shop is going to be worth 40 gold, which is quite nice, actually. Okay, so let's go ahead and first drink. So let's for this turn we can just put those there. So these guys are still building. Yeah, so he's still got to. Right, so like working these 3 mines would be quite nice. So who else is building? Anybody else working on great people? So Lalibela and Addis Ababa. I don't actually need one super quickly. Alright, so we'll wait here in the next turn. We will really 4 turns to Code of Laws, and Code of Laws still has not been founded, which is really late, so I'm kinda holding my breath here. I mean, the very next thing I would do would be to convert Hattie, and then that would be nice. Well, you gotta be like that, huh? So hopefully when we're on the same religion, she will no longer hate me. Also, Gepid, which is over here. wow, that seems like destined for them to hate each other. The library. She does have ivory, which I don't. Okay, so now let's go back here to research. Alright, so I want you to work these tiles. That's fine, and then you're gonna do that. Alright, so that's basically banking 22 gold per turn in the future. So now you can take this. Search another one, which actually I want you to take this, because I really want to max out my capital just because it's the one that has the academy. Let's see. Alright, fine. Now let me move this guy so it'll stop jumping around. Okay. And so at 9 turns to a hamlet. Yeah, so I really want to work this guy here. I like you just fine, except, yeah, so he's fine, okay. Yeah, that looks good too. Alright, okay, so 3 turns Dakota Laws, working over here, tech-wise. Okay, these guys still won't trade math because they're jerks. So I'm going to swap over here and build and put the overflow into Schwedigan Paya. So that's, yeah, so 30 overflow. So yeah, at least 64 gold. Now I just got to hope somebody builds the stupid thing. Alright, so still nobody with Coda Laws. So I really just have to hold my breath one turn, because if it doesn't go on this next inner turn, player wins ties. I probably want to. I don't know that anybody wants my corn. Could trade my horse, but nobody really. She has horses. I'm not you. He doesn't have horses, but. Maybe he does. Okay. So they definitely don't like each other. Alright, so should get Coat of Laws next turn. Okay, so she is going currency. So that is nice. Alright, everybody's unhappy, which, you know, there's nothing much I can do there. Okay, so let's put you on research. And go back to doing this, just because it makes more beakers, base beakers per turn. Actually can't even, no she can, why can't she research Code of Laws? Oh, she has priesthood. Okay, he can't research Code of Laws because he doesn't have priesthood. Still none of them will trade math, which is kind of annoying. I guess next I'm gonna, well, so does he have literature? I forgot to check. So he doesn't have literature, but wow, I just have so little production here. I don't know that I can really build the Great Library.
To bring about the rule of righteousness in the land so that the strong should not harm the weak.
Probably are going to do that, but not this second. Okay, so... yeah, I think right to monarchy. I could... Well, yeah, I don't really want... I mean, I do want monotheism. Maybe... Getting monotheism would save me beakers on monarchy, and I do want that for organized religion, so yeah, I'm actually going to do that. I'm going to turn my slider down a little bit. Alright, Confucianism and Lalibela over here, okay. Alright. The horns of war, I gotta say, it gave me a little bit of a fright. Okay. Okay, so... Again, nobody will trade math. I'm gonna wait on this. She's gonna get currency in a few turns, and that will hopefully give me some extra. Okay, so then, I'll wait maybe until she converts to...
Not at all similar are the race of the immortal gods and the race of men who walk upon the earth.
Thought maybe this was a settling party to settle this. Like I said, I'm surprised that she hasn't settled this yet. Okay, Augustus Caesar has completed the Hanging Gardens. Hopefully that means that they will trade math. Nope, I didn't mean to go there. I thought that was there was a road there. Okay. Yay, they will all trade math now. Okay. So... So she would do that. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Yeah, I know you don't like me because okay, she will trade banana. I don't really need help as much as I do.
If in other sciences we should arrive at certainty without doubt and truth without error, it behooves us to place the foundations of knowledge in mathematics.
All right. So looking good. Here I am growing into unhappiness, which is, let me just kind of run through this and... Second scientist there. And then I really need probably to whip some... Well, I'd rather not whip a monastery. I'd rather get into organized religion so that I can whip missionaries directly. The capital is going to want a monastery. Yeah, so that's another reason why I'd go monotheism. That way I can double switch into organized religion and hereditary rule. She did find us there.
It is from their foes, not their friends, that cities learn the lesson of building high walls.
Yeah. Okay, so she did put a city there as expected. Okay. Alright, so that's fine. I can probably move this guy back into my borders and probably save me a few beakers per turn. Okay. So he could go here and convert source thieves. This is all the way down there. I'm just going to go ahead and convert this guy right here. And guess I can work a little bit on the road network over here. I don't really see any other building improvements to make. So tech-wise, I mean, I'm really going quite a bit, you know, very, very well here. I've got a religion, which would be nice, right? Especially if I can share it. I mean, it's unfortunate that I'm unlikely to ever get a prophet for a shrine. But not much I can do about that. I'm trying to think of what I no, so I'm what are my strengths again? I'm creative, which is Library Theater Coliseum, and organized, which is Lighthouse. So yeah, I actually probably want to build a few courthouses here. I mean, maintenance is not bad, actually. You know, it's a lot of beavers, but they're cheap courthouses, and it would be something to whip. Since they're, like, they're basically just be whipping off unhappy citizens. So yeah, that would be... I'm sure my triple whip. In a second. My spy points wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. So let me... Sorry, buddy. Like a building scrap city in the middle of nowhere. Nice. I guess I could probably chop this into sure. Yeah, that would be nice.
I can sell a seller priesthood and some of their other cheap
texts.
I'm
What kind of thing
that they need to do the player can do, because they can discount, just fine.
Not watching, nice.
Somebody can build ship teams. I don't have the doubler.
Trading, iron working round, I guess. Please, nice guy. Shock trade calendar. Such a nice. Do they even have monarchy? Do you have monarchy? No, he doesn't have. He doesn't have priesthood or. Right. Hattie is probably building a mausoleum. Marble, nice. Alright, can I get monarchy in one turn? Yeah, I can.
13. Okay, perfect. Yeah, because then I can hook up the wines. I can double revolt. Yeah, and then I can start getting rid of some of these unhappy faces with hereditary rule. Okay, and this is, I'm double revolting because I'm double revolting to organize religion and hereditary rule, and I'm gonna revolt in two turns because I'm gonna, well, I'll probably wait to convert to Confucianism just yet. I was thinking I would revolt in two turns in a row, but I think. Okay.
A multitude of rulers is not a good thing.
Okay.
Let that be one ruler, one king.
We'll say civil service for now, at least. Confucianism and nice free spread. Alright, so we got the iron mine. Statue of Zeus, mausoleum. Wow, this is a bunch of wonders of this one. So, Parthenon, statue of Zeus, and the mausoleum. Thanks for building the mausoleum for me, Hattie. Appreciate it. Okay, so we're putting you back into. We still got that in their queue. All right, it's you. Okay, that was. All right, so I think. Monarchy is 507. Could I get so I can't even get that from him. But I could. So I could get that from Monarchy and Alphabet. I could get a calendar and then. Oh, she still won't trade currency. Alright, well, I'm just gonna wait. So let me revolt. So, oh, that, I must have missed that. Alright, so Confucian Monastery for sure, there. I'll give, yeah. Alright, I guess there's no point in doing that right now since I've got no research or anything. Egypt's going for construction. Okay, well now. Yeah, so I can double whip that next turn. Keep him on Schwedigen. Okay, Christianity has been founded in Alexandria. Well, that's annoying, because then she's probably going to convert to that. Unless I really spam her with missionaries, which I am going to do. Okay, so Confucian missionary here, and then I can double pop, I can double whip that next turn. Do I not get? Oh, because it's not my state religion. Right. Which actually go ahead and I'm going to hope that I can get enough missionaries to keep her Confucianness. And she is spiritual, so she doesn't cost her to revolt. I mean, it doesn't cost her any anarchy to revolt. Okay. Do you have this? Yeah. Okay, so he's got the letters. Nice. I approve. Alright, so I'm going to just save gold for a few turns. Someone to build Schwedigan Paya for sure. Okay, so I could still get calendar, but oh yeah, now you don't like me anymore? Jerk. Hey, thank you for completing Schwedigan Paya. Alright. So just because I don't have stone. I'm gonna build a lighthouse. Actually, yeah, so I'm gonna build a Confucian missionary. Archer, just for a chariot, maybe for hereditary rule purposes. So these warriors. Let's see. So you. She has 60 gold now, so if I... She's going for construction, but she probably won't trade that. Yeah, so I could get 60 gold. Really would prefer to be able to... Yeah, I'm going to wait on that. Monarchy is a monopoly tech for me right now. So actually, so looking at my choices here... Yeah, actually, wasn't I saying I was going to go for... Great library? Yeah, actually, let me do that. That would be another tech that nobody has. Yeah, and I've got all that fail gold from... No, not that. Yeah, still doesn't have literature. So... Yeah, so I got... 84, 106, 100, yeah, so like 400 gold from that. Confucianism spread in Rome, in Iridium, so that is awesome news as well. Want this city to grow, so I probably want to even take this back, which means yep, that's looking just fine. Okay, else for this guy to do? Not really. So I'm just gonna bring him back here. Okay, so no, I don't want you to overflow into a barracks. I want you to overflow into another Confucian missionary. Hit F for fortify when I meant to hit G for go. So yeah, I do need some roads over here to get movement for these guys. Okay, you also need to whip a Confucian missionary. And from my perspective, I have two cities that I want to convert, but I really need to make sure that Hattie stays Confucian, or she's not going to like me. Go back into research. Once again, also Gondar. Gondar got a free spread in Thebes also. Nice. Okay, I'm probably... I'm gonna go down here to Memphis. Okay, so I got the wines too. So yeah, looking... those are connected, okay. Trade resources, so they would take wines for, wines for gems would be nice. Actually, wines for ivory would be even better. So, but I doubt she would do that. But I will do wines for sugar. For fair trade bonus. Okay. So... send one of you here to chop that before I lose that tile. And you. Man, I got a bad problem hitting F when I need to hit G. Alright, next turn, literature. So she will trade me construction. I doubt I can get both of those. But I bet if I put some turns into one of those, I might be able to. Man, I really gotta give you currency. Lady. Yeah, I mean, there's no real point in... Well, so I do get a 25% bonus. So I'll go ahead and... But I really want him to grow to the happy cap. So let me... work some of these cottages for the capital. So there's no point in delaying there since I'm not getting the organized religion bonus. Okay. So I can't. Here I cannot. I already have three missionaries in flight. So there's something I can whip here to. Really anything super useful. Barracks, I suppose. I could chop this. Maybe next turn I'll chop this into a Confucian missionary.
Some books are to be tasted, others to be swallowed, and some few to be chewed and digested.
I could go music, actually. Great artists. Yeah. I'm going to stay and go with civil service here. Okay, so you got, again, with the F. Chepset converts to Christianity. You Yeah, I suspected that might happen. She is going for literature. Okay, so there's no way that I'm going to beat her to the Great Library, I think. But we'll give it the old college try.
I don't mean to know.
So I'm going to just... Never mind. Shaka converts to Christianity. Oh, this is all going horribly wrong. Guess let's send you out here. Didn't convert to okay, so she will give me 100 gold now, which I don't really need the gold. I wish one of these other guys would get currency. That's what I really wish. Oh, so she is spreading Confucianism. Nice. And so I could actually, so she's going for drama. Why can't I ask her to? Why can't I ask for her to convert? Oh, maybe she hasn't been 5 turns yet. Because that's something I could look to do. Calendar. Yeah, probably next turn once it grows to 9, maybe I can use those 2 mines. I mean, there really aren't any other buildings worth having. I'd like the Heroic Epic, and here in Gondar as well, but I don't have a... I don't have a unit of 10 experience points. Yeah, okay. So if I trade... is probably worth doing. So she will. Would I be able to do it for construction? Okay. So could I then get a small effects? Antium captured by the Zulus. Wow. Okay, so I do that, and then I could get calendar. Yeah. Okay, so let me do that. Could I get her to declare war on Shaka? Okay. I didn't think so. Could I even. Would I get her to declare war on Shaka? It's not even free. Okay, so. Yeah, so now she loves me. She's even forgotten about that time that she wanted me to do something.
For everything, there is a season and a time for every purpose under heaven.
So that's looking good. Now I can get. So now she won't. Now he won't trade me. That's probably because I traded with his worst enemies or something. And you won't trade. Wait. Did I get that for calendar? Oh, alright. I gotta reload that one because that was just a misclick. So normally I don't like to reload, but sometimes when it's like clearly something that I didn't mean to do and then hit the wrong button, I will end up doing that. And I think I just killed the game. So wait for it. So probably gonna stream for maybe another few minutes, maybe 10 minutes, and then hopefully finish this up a little bit later. Come on. Okay. Loading. I don't know why that crashed the game. Okay. So, loading. Okay, so am I on the right turn here? Okay. Construction, not calendar. Okay, she again, she loves me.
And on the pedestal, these words appear. My name is Ozymandias, King of Kings. Look on my works, ye mighty, and despair.
Okay, so he will do that for alphabet, priesthood, and literature, which is what I suspected. Yeah, I mean, I guess he could trade literature to Augustus. Metal casting would be nice. Probably get. She's probably not going to trade that while she's building the Great Library. Oh wait, they're in a war. Why would they? They're not going to be trading. Okay. Shepsa converts to Confucianism. How nice. Right. Calendar so I can get my spices.
For everything, there is a season and a time for every purpose under heaven.
Okay. So everybody is pleased with me, which is good. Okay, so let me. 17 turns. Slightly off because I will get that. Okay, I can work that cottage there. And that one. There, okay. Alright. Now they've made peace. Probably for literature. Oh, for he gave him metal casting. Nice. Okay, so can I get that? Would be awesome if I could get this. Yeah, I didn't think so. Okay, never mind. Alright, so I can start building the plantation. few turns off the Great Library. Confucian Missionary. Okay, so... obviously there's much for him to do, so I'm just gonna get him back in my territory. Yeah, I mean, going... really, yeah, so trying to think about the next few steps. I do probably want to get to optics and astronomy to meet the other three civs. If I look at optics, that would require, excuse me, so metal casting, compass, machinery, optics, like living astronomy maybe is a play here. Wonder if it would be worth going into caste system, because I could run quite a few. Yeah, I probably do want to do that. And there's nothing really I want to whip anymore. I hate, but like being able to get. Well, maybe let me get. See if I can get my first scientist here. It's really 18 turns. Okay. Bulbing philosophy. Yeah, so that's, I mean, that's the next thing that they would bulb. That would be nice, too. Yeah, and actually, now that I'm thinking about it, with Hatshepsut having theologies, building the apostolic palace in Confucianism would be nice. Yeah, so maybe when I'm going to want to revolt to bureaucracy, actually, in 3 turns. So maybe on 3 turns I'll switch to caste and... bureaucracy. Yeah, because that would be huge for the Great Library also. Yeah, so I probably don't have enough oomph to get this in short 220. Yeah, so giant 8 gold from... I wonder actually if I could get... So he can't convert to religion. Okay. That'd be great, actually, if I get everybody but Shaka to be Confucian. That'd be fantastic. Okay, so I feel like Hattie is in a good place here. So I need, yeah, I still have one more of my cities that hasn't been converted, so I'll go ahead and do that. Oh, I forgot I have incense over here too. Yeah, stop that. Okay, you just chill there. I'm gonna play maybe 2 more turns when I get civil service, and then maybe quit them. That chop on unit. Cottage for the capital. Probably should probably go in for music, which makes sense. Please don't do a culture bomb in Giza or in, I guess, yeah, it's just so far away, it doesn't really matter. There's no real point in just keep finish the barracks.
The bureaucracy is expanding to meet the needs of the expanding bureaucracy.
All right, probably paper. Could beat her. Oh no, she's got. She's. Let's see. I thought I could beat her to the Great Harvest. I mean, I could have if I had started back when I first talked about it. Go ahead and... Okay. Oh, so she will trade metal casting. Yes, I would. Maybe if I put a few turns into that, I could get that from Shotgun. Yeah, so I think I'm gonna pause it here. I think the idea would be to go towards astronomy, really optics and astronomy. Here I've got, yeah, so this would be another 100% hammers, 50%, 50%. So that would be, turn that from 15 to plus 75%, so call it 11 more, so 20, so an extra 8, yeah, basically an extra 7 or 8 beakers per turn. So that would be 26, I'm gonna make it 26, and I'm short 217, so maybe 8 turns, yeah, shave 5 turns off, 4 turns if you count that it's... I have to spend a turn in Anarchy. Really, I should do this, too, because that's giving me an extra beaker, which means I want to... work this guy instead. Alright. So, everyone, thanks for joining, and yep, catch you next time.